Good morning and welcome to Tribe Talk. We are happy to be here with you 2 days in a row. I'm Peyton Borchelt.
And I'm Jules Roderick. Today is Friday, February 3rd, day 3. Hope you remembered your coat because it's a little chilly outside and Punxsutawney Phil saw his shadow yesterday. Get ready for 6 more weeks of winter. Today's weather is partly cloudy with a high of 25 and a low of 10. Tomorrow will be not be much warmer with a high of 25 and a low of 21. But don't worry, over the weekend it's looking like temperatures will rise a little bit. Today's lunch is Mac Sticks, or a burger without cheese, with or without cheese. Size include your choice of either pears, salad, or pudding. Stay tuned for next week's lunch.
Remember, the daily lunch is posted outside the cafeteria. Due to course selection this week, you will be reporting to different classes during IE for course discussions. Today, report to your Period 3 Odd class. February 6th, report to Period 5 Even. February 7th, go to Period 5 Odd. February 8th, go to Period 6 Even, and February 9th, go to Period 6 Odd. Good luck in selecting your courses. The UP Film Critics Society will be kicking off the second semester with a showing of Jim Henson's 1986 fantasy classic Labyrinth on Wednesday, February 8th at 2:45 p.m. in room 421. Labyrinth follows the story of a girl navigating through a maze of adventures to rescue her younger brothers from the clutches of the evil Goblin King. Come on out and bring a snack and a friend. See you there. Lynn Crew is hosting a dodgeball tournament on Wednesday, February 15th.
Did you hear Lynn Crew's hosting a dodgeball tournament?
Yeah, dude, I heard. I'm so excited.
We gotta get a team together, bro.
Yeah, we really do.
Yo, you guys were talking about dodgeball? What's that?
The dodgeball tournament is going to take place on February 15th after school. It's going to start sometime a little bit before 3 o'clock. Teams have to be of 6 people with a minimum of 2 females. It's $5 per person, so $30 for the team. You're guaranteed 4 games minimum, and then there'll be playoffs after that. And each game is like 3 minutes. So depending on how many teams sign up, we'll determine how long it's going to go. In order to sign up, you need to get a piece of paper from outside of either my room, Smo's room, Mr. Hansley, or Mrs. Paul, and then payment is due to one of those advisors.
Get your teams together now. Tickets are $5 per person, and the event starts right after school on the 15th.
Don't forget that the Polar Plunge is coming up.
Polar Plunge is a fundraising event that Special Olympics puts on every year. They have multiple events around Pennsylvania. This year, we're going to participate in the one in Citizens Bank Park. We've been fundraising for the past 2 months. We actually just met our goal of over $1,500 just last week. So, you know, the plunging aspect of it is just kind of make it a fun event, you know, instead of just donating to the cause. So it's just to, you know, get more publicity out there for people to make them aware of what Special Olympics is. My permission form's outside of room 109, and anyone, you know, is able to fill out a permission form until the bus is full. Obviously, just like any field trip, people have to, you know, have their teacher sign off that it's okay that they're missing this time. The event will be leaving here around 9 in the morning on February 10th, and we'll be getting back between 12:30 and 1, I'm hoping. It does not cost any money. So people have been fundraising, people in the community have been fundraising, making donations. Every Friday, there's an email that goes out to the entire school district. It's one of the topics that's added to there, and families have been going on, and staff have been going on and making contributions. So anyone that is signing up, there is no cost for those individuals to participate.
If you have any questions, talk to Mr. Thrush and make sure to look for the footage of the event coming up. Do you have any books that you don't have room for anymore? The library is accepting donations of gently used, school-appropriate books starting on January 16th. The books will be used in the library or we donate to our local public libraries. If you have any questions, talk to Mrs. Staddle in the library. Mamma Mia is coming soon and tickets for the show are on sale now. The musical runs from March 9th to March 12th. Student night is on Thursday, March 9th, starting at 7 p.m. Tickets are available for $5 and can be purchased online or by scanning the QR code. Tickets will be on sale at the door each night of the show. Do you love to sing? Auditions for next year's Uptown Women's Choir are taking place now through Friday, February 3rd. Please see Dr. Thomas in the choir room to sign up for an audition time. Now over to Payne for some sports updates.
Thanks, Jules. Last night, girls basketball won their senior night game against Pottstown with a score of 56-20. Great job, girls. Wrestling also won their senior night on Wednesday against Pottsgrove with a score of 40-21. That's all the news we have for today. We want to help you advertise your events and updates. Be sure to scan the QR code outside of Ms. Barker's room to submit any stories or projects that you would like to use or would like us to use on air. If you ever miss a day of Tribe Talk or want to watch again, you can find all of our content on YouTube. Be sure to search Upper Perk Network and look for our new logo.
And a reminder to follow our Instagram page at Upper Perk News for school updates and fun Tribe Talk content. Thank you for watching. Have a fabulous Friday and a wonderful weekend.